Hi everyone. So in this video, we will look at one method to calculate the Jacobian matrix, and that would be the partial differentiation method. So a quick recap from my previous video, the Jacobian is used in robotics to relate the joint velocities to the Cartesian velocities. When solving a problem, we would start off by finding the position of these joints. We would then differentiate this to find the velocity and thereby the Jacobian. So the Jacobian can be used mainly to find the singularities along with torques and forces that can act on the joints. If you're not quite familiar with the basics of the Jacobian matrix, do check out my previous video on an introduction to the Jacobian by clicking the link up here. Without waiting any longer, let's get into it. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button. And if you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button right now. I'm Chums, and welcome to That's Engineering. Alright, so let's have a look at the general form of the partial differentiation equation when trying to find the Jacobian. So something to note is that the Jacobian is all about finding the velocities of the joints. Right, so our first few calculations that we do would actually give us the position of these joints, and depending on the joints we have, we can have a multitude of equations. So for example, y1 would be equal to some sort of function f1 with variables x1, x2, x3, and so on. We can have the second one with a function f2 and we can have any number of equations, and all these equations would represent the position of the joints in the robot. Now, to find the velocity, we would have to differentiate the position vectors, and by doing this, we would get a set of velocity equations. Now, keeping in mind that there are multiple variables here, so we will use partial differentiation. So you would have something like daba y1 would be daba f1 over daba x1 plus daba f1 over x2 and so on. And you would have the same for y2 with f2 instead of x1. And you would have multiple velocity equations equating the number of the position equations. So we can write this in a general format such that daba y is equal to daba f over daba x times daba x. And this would actually be a matrix. So you would have y1 dot, y2 dot, and so on, equal to some matrix containing all the coefficients of this particular function, this derivative, times a matrix with the derivative of the variables. And this matrix df or daba f over daba x would be the Jacobian of this system. So we can generalize this to an equation such that y dot would be equal to the Jacobian times x dot. And this equation you should remember, as it will help you when finding the Jacobian. Alright, so let's have a look at the order of operations when solving a problem. So from the beginning, you would have a robot and you would be able to assign frames to that robot, and after analysis of these frames, you should be able to form a DH table. And based on the values from your DH table, you should be able to find the transformation matrices from one joint to another. Right, so the transformation matrices would look something like T01, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and so on, depending on the number of joints in your system. So using these transformation matrices, you can find one transformation matrix that would represent the base frame to the final frame. In this case, I've used 3 as an example. And it would be equal to 01 times the transformation matrix 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. And it would be in a form similar to a 4x4 matrix with a rotation matrix and 3 position vectors. Right, so these position vectors would have 3 components. You would have a px, py, and pz term. And these 3 would show the position of the tool or the final frame relative to the base of the robot. Right. The next step, or the third step, would be to differentiate these position equations to find the velocity equations. And they can be represented as a matrix. So you would have px dot, py dot, pz dot. And it would be equal to the Jacobian times whatever variables existed in the system. Right, so to give you a quick example, to make it a little easier, just imagine you had some system and you found your position vector in x as r1 cos theta. Let's say py was r2 sine theta and pz was 0. So differentiating these would give you px dot to be equal to minus r1 sine theta times theta dot. Py dot would be r2 cos theta times theta dot. And pz dot would be 0. Now this can be rewritten in the format px dot, py dot, pz dot. You would have negative r1 sine theta, r2 cos theta, and 0 times theta dot. Right, so this would be in the format y dot would be equal to the Jacobian times x dot, making this matrix the Jacobian of the system, keeping in mind that it's Jacobian in the base frame as we use the transformation matrix base frame relative to the final frame. Alright, so to make things clearer, let's go through a quick worked example. Here, we are given a robot with 2 joints and its corresponding DH table. The question asks us to find the velocity of the tip of the arm in terms of the 0th frame or the base frame and the 2nd frame. So the first step in solving this problem would be to find the transformation matrices. using the DH table. So to do that, we can simply use these set of equations, plug in the values from the DH table, and find our two transformation matrices. Feel free to pause the video and give this a go before I continue. Alright, so if you did find the two transformation matrices, you should get these as your answers for the transformation matrix from the first 0th frame to the first frame, and from the first frame to the second frame. So now that we know the transformation matrix from the base frame to the second frame, we can answer the first part of this question, which wants the velocity in terms of the base frame. So what we do here would be to take the position vector of the final frame relative to the first frame. So you would have px, py, and pz. Px would be equal to L2 cos theta 1 plus L1. Py would be L2 sine theta 1, and pz would be 0. We can then differentiate these three values to get px dot equal to L2 sine theta 1, negative L2 sine theta 1, into theta 1 dot. Py would be L2 cos theta 1 into theta 1 dot, and pz dot would be 0. So from these three, we can rearrange it in this form, in the matrix form, to have px, py, pz, our terms for the function, times theta 1 dot, making this matrix here the Jacobian. Right, so actually what the question is looking for are these three equations, as these three equations would be the velocity of the tool relative to frame 0. So these three equations would be the answer to the first part of the question. But from this, we can find the Jacobian in the 0th frame. So to elaborate a bit more, this is in the form y dot equals j x dot. And the velocity in the 0th frame would be the Jacobian in the 0th frame times theta 1 dot. Alright, so now we can move on to the second part of the question. So in the first part, we found that the velocity in the 0th frame was equal to the Jacobian in the 0th frame times theta 1 dot. So we can deduce that the velocity in the second frame would be equal to the Jacobian in the second frame times theta 1 dot. So now we have to find the Jacobian in the second frame. And if you remember my previous video, I discussed how we can change the frames that the Jacobian is given relative to, and that can be done using the rotation matrix of the transformation matrix. So the Jacobian in the second frame would be equal to the rotation matrix 2 to 0 times the Jacobian in the 0th frame. So now we have to find this rotation matrix 2 to 0. Looking at this transformation matrix, this region would be the rotation matrix. But this would give us the rotation matrix 0 to 2. Hence, you would have to find the inverse of this matrix to find the rotation matrix of 2 to 0. given that this is a simple 3x3 matrix, the inverse of this matrix can be directly calculated by transposing the columns into the rows. Therefore, this would be equal to the rotation matrix 2 to 0, it has been transposed, times the Jacobian in the 0th frame. And if you do this, you should get this as your final answer. Alright, so the final step would be to find the velocity in the 2nd frame, given that now we have the Jacobian in the 2nd frame, and all we have to do is multiply it by theta 1 dot. So you can rewrite this out as minus L2 cos 1 2 sine 1 plus L2 sine 1 2 cos 1. L2 sine 1 2 sine 1 plus L2 cos 1 2 cos 1 and 0. You can multiply this out by theta 1 dot. And if you multiply each term out, you would get three equations, the last equation being 0, which would correspond to the velocity relative to the 2nd frame. Alright guys, so that's all for this video. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button below. Now, if you have any questions or clarifications on the work we just did involving the partial differentiation method to find the Jacobian matrix, feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to you. I hope this video helped you, and if you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that subscribe button right now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Cheers!